Hello, everyone. First, it's a great honor to be here. And I would like to sincerely thank the Brain Foundation and their donors for the generous gift. I would also like to thank my co-investigator, Associate Professor Sandy Schultz, and my mentor, Professor Terence O'Brien. Ischemic stroke, as we have heard today, it's a common neurological condition that results in debilitating lifelong consequences. One of the most severe, yet understudied consequences of a stroke is the development of post-stroke epilepsy. Unfortunately, there is no current intervention known to prevent the long-term consequences of a stroke. Tau is a protein that plays a critical role in the normal function of the neurons. Tau undergoes phosphorylation and dephosphorylation changes that are tightly regulated by the protein phosphatase 2A, or just PP2A. However, we have shown that in a number of neurodegenerative diseases like traumatic brain injury, Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's, and epilepsy, there's a dysfunction of PP2A, and also tau appears to be hyperphosphorylated. This hyperphosphorylation of tau creates aggregates of the tau protein that destabilize the structure of the neurons and impairs the function of the neurons, leading to neuronal death, which promotes the development of different brain diseases. We have previously shown that treatment with sodium selenate, which is a drug that improves the function of PP2A, helps to decrease the hyperphosphorylation of tau and improves the outcomes after traumatic brain injury. We now have very exciting preliminary data showing that tau is hyperphosphorylated and PP2A is dysfunctions in a model of ischemic stroke. So based on these promising results, this project will now test the hypothesis that hyperphosphorylated tau and PP2A contribute to the brain damage and consequences of a stroke. We will also evaluate if the treatment with sodium selenate can prevent brain damage, mobility impairments, chronic pain, anxiety, depression, learning and memory deficits, and epilepsy after a stroke. Sodium selenate, it's already in clinical trials in other neurological conditions, and thus, this project has a strong potential to impact the medical management of stroke patients in the foreseeable future. I would like to thank again the Brain Foundation and their donors for their support to science and to our research. Thank you very much.